Welcome back to the Friday Night Frenzy.
West Lafayette Red Devils head coach Marshall Overlead joins us. Coach, glad you can be here. It was a really good night for you. You get the win, and numbers 1 and 2 and 3A both get knocked off.
Well, first of all, we're glad we got the win. You know, coaches, we want to take care of the business out there, and Twin Lakes is a good team. I think Brad Urban's really working hard getting that team going, and we wanted to make sure we took care of business, and we're glad to get the win.
Red Devils beat Twin Lakes tonight by a final of 30-6. They are ranked third in the state, but like Ross said, the top two teams lost, so very likely could be number 1 in the state. Marshall, okay. We've got you on. We've got to ask. Next week, you play Seager. In 2 weeks, the big old elephant in the room, you've got Central Catholic. And I mean this. How do you get yourself, the coaches, and the players to focus on Seager? And I'm not disrespecting Seager.
Well, thank you. And I don't think we will. We keep pointing out John Wooden's quote, to fear no opponent, respect every opponent. We have seniors. And the seniors know this is their last time around. And they understand where the C's going to go, but they also understand it's a gain of time. Also, it's important, I think, for football players to realize they have a specific job, and they aren't looking at much at the whole game. They're looking at their individual man across the line from them, and that helps them stay focused on the game.
And that game in 2 weeks will be an emotional game, as was tonight with senior night. You talked about the seniors. You have 20 seniors in this group.
We have 20 seniors.
Just talk about
and that games. It was emotional for a lot of us, for the parents, to be able to walk with your son, realizing that the football season is ending. It's a tough thing, and it always is difficult for a team to focus after that.
All right, Marshall Overlead, the outstanding first-class coach of the West Lafayette Red Devils. They're now 7-0 in the season after their win tonight.
Real quick, you buying Brunos for everybody after you beat CC the last week of the season?
Just kidding. We got Seager ahead. You know that, Ross. Thanks, we got Seager ahead.
All right, South Newton hosting Caston. Thanks, Coach. Yes. Rebels in pink to tackle cancer, a great cause there by South Newton High School. Quarterback Luke Welsh on the keeper. He takes it all the way. So the Rebels are going to try for two after that South Newton touchdown. And Welsh, after that touchdown, will take it in easily. So it is 8-0 South Newton. The Rebels having a good season. Caston Commons respond later in the first quarter. And Michael Smith running the ball in for a touchdown. But the Rebels go on to win this contest by final of 26-21. Ross?
Rensselaer has been hosting Delphi this evening, and it was a wet one out there. Less than a minute left in the first quarter. Bombers up. Keaton Lyons breaks through the Oracle's defense for a touchdown. Rensselaer goes for two, so it's 24-0 at that point. Second quarter, Eli Lawson is just too fast for Delphi's defense. He takes it all the way. Check out this defense. Lyons, he's playing some D. He takes him down, and it's Lyons again, this time on offense. Another touchdown for the Bombers. The Bombers going to win in a big way. 58-0 is the final. And that'll do it for tonight's edition of the Friday Night Frenzy.
For more Frenzy-related features, including bonus highlights of tonight's games, just go to our website, WLFI.com.
Thanks again for Coach Overlead. Have a great weekend.
Good night.